Again, nails. We discussed several times about the nails, but look, here, in fact, if you observe, well, I have longer the left-hand nails than the right-hand nails, and the thumb is also short. Should be not like a dagger or something to, you know. So this short, and then you have more control to combine the sound between flesh and nail. Otherwise, the sound will be thinner if you play just naily stuff. And also, that the point where you press is this point. I mark it there on purpose to show you that you have to actually press there in this point and not play just superficially with the, this is nail sound, which is thinner, and this is the other, the flesh plus nail sound. Some friends, I have two actually, Peter and Thomas, who are also experts of massage thing, and they work, their work is with this massage stuff, and therefore they cannot have long nails, so no problem. Even if someone has no long nails, there is no problem. If you have too much nail, there is problem, because the posture will be, if you have too long, then it will tend to bend here, you have to have the hand fallen, the posture, it modifies that thing. But in the sound, as far as possible, if we keep this short enough, this is the change, because in Savica's time, nails were very long, and now we have totally short these things. In fact, they have more in the left hand now than in the right hand. And by the way, left hand should also not be too short. Otherwise here, for the ligado and this, we will have a problem, Houston, again. Okay, so that was just that, to try to keep them also in the same shape of the finger. You see, same shape. Of course, this is a very personal thing, but before, in flamenco, nails were very long. So not anymore. You see, you don't need more than this, actually, because here you can do dynamics of flesh, then more nail, by turning this angle here. So from here, you don't need more than this. Of course, it's ideal for the posture, because you can have it close to the... That is because of the fact that the nail should not be too much above the flesh. And then when you have flexed the finger, if it changed that, of course, it also depends on the growth of each one's anatomical constitution. With this growth of the nails, it's in different spots. But yeah, in fact, if you keep shorter the nails, or even without nail, that's not the ideal thing. But if you don't have any nail here, you can also play. On the other hand, if nails are too long, that's not good, and for sure it's the old school. So this is how we work with the Paco de Lucía's technique.
La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?
Pablo, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.